Hey everybody, this is Elon Osborne, and this is my YouTube channel where I talk about movies, audio, and music. And if you like watching videos about that kind of thing, please consider hitting that like button and subscribing, because it's my mission to bring you everything home theater and audio related, but trying to entertain you at the same time. Now, you might have seen that Emotiva just launched a second generation of their Basics amplifiers. For a while there, I thought it was Base X, but then I watched their video and he definitely says Basics. It's their basic amplifier option. So, makes sense, right? This second generation of amplifiers that they've come out with just totally blows their previous generation out of the water, because now you have many more options to choose from. They released the A2, A3, A4, A5, and A7 amplifiers. So now you have the option of having a 2-channel, 3-channel, 4-channel, 5-channel, or 7-channel amplifier. Honestly, this is huge home theater news, especially when it comes to the 2 and 3 and 4-channel options. Sure, there are a lot of 2-channel options out there, but that's more geared towards a lot of hi-fi equipment, so a lot of 2-channel amplifiers can be really, really expensive. Tens of thousands of dollars even. But Emotiva is a trusted brand in consumer home theater electronics. And since this particular line of amplifiers does not have XLR inputs, they only have RCA inputs, that means they are going to be less expensive than their XLR counterparts. But this is still Emotiva, so you're going to get high quality RCA Class AB amplification. Let's focus on the A2 for a second. The Basics A2 is a 2-channel power amplifier that delivers 160 watts per channel into 8 ohms and 250 watts per channel into 4 ohms. The reason this is very important in the home theater realm is because a lot of your higher end receivers like 9 channels, 11 channels, 13 channels, they all have pre-outs. And all of the higher end receivers like that can actually handle an additional 2 channels of processing if they are powered by an external amplifier. So this Basics A2 amplifier is perfect for that scenario. Say for example you have a Marantz SR6015 or 7015, those are 9-channel amplifiers with preamps. But you can have a total of 11 channels being processed if you use the Basics A2 with it. Next is what I probably think is going to sell the most, and that is the 3-channel Basics A3. Like I've mentioned in previous videos, the brunt of all the sound that comes from your home theater setup is going to be your front left, center, and front right speakers, what's also known as the front sound stage. But up until this point, you were really out of luck trying to find a decent, inexpensive 3-channel amplifier. I mean, sure, Emotiva does offer the XBA3 amplifier, but it's $1,200. And that's basically what you're gonna find with other amplifiers out there as well. But with the launch of the Basics A3 3-channel amplifier, it totally changes the game. The Basics A3 delivers 140 watts per channel into 8 ohms and 200 watts per channel into 4 ohms. And what I love about Emotiva's information that you can find online is that they don't beat around the bush. As you can see here, there are 3 very important words: all channels driven. All the other receiver manufacturers out there, Sony, Denon, Onkyo, Marantz, you name it, what they're gonna tell you is that the rated wattage is only gonna be for 2 channels driven. So if it states that it's gonna be 125 watts per channel, that only means 2 channels. When you're driving 3 channels, 5 channels, 9 channels, what does that actually equate to? Who knows? 30, 40, 50, 60 watts max maybe? So the fact that you know right up front that the Basics A3 is going to deliver 140 watts per channel is saying a lot. So that's going to be plenty of power for some nice tower speakers and a big old center speaker. Next up is the Basics A4 4-channel amplifier. The A4 delivers 100 watts per channel into 8 ohms and 130 watts per channel into 4 ohms. This particular amplifier is going to be perfect for those who want to power their height channels. They have 4 height channels in the ceiling, for example. But beyond the home theater realm, I believe the 4-channel amplifier is going to be very popular among hi-fi enthusiasts. Because with 4 channels of power amplification, you can actually use it to bi-amp 2 stereo speakers in your hi-fi setup for incredible sounding music. Because if you care about bi-amping, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Next up is the Basics A5 5-channel amp. The A5 delivers 95 watts per channel into 8 ohms and 130 watts per channel into 4 ohms. This is going to be important for those who have, say, a 5.1.4 setup, because then you can power all of your bed layer speakers with this amp, meaning your 3 front stage speakers and your 2 surround speakers all powered by an external amp. And then you can let the internal amps of your receiver power your height channels. And last but not least, we have the Basics A7 7-channel amplifier. The A7 delivers 90 watts per channel into 8 ohms and 125 watts per channel into 4 ohms. This particular amp is going to be very important for those who would like to give some extra power to your bed layer speakers if you happen to have a 7.1 or maybe even a 7.1.2, 7.1.4. So that way all of your bed layer speakers have that extra power that you need. And that not only gives extra power to the speakers themselves, but it also gives extra processing power to your receiver, because the receiver itself doesn't have to worry about powering 7 bed layer speakers. So it will just be able to handle the load much better. So that will result in a cleaner, much more detailed soundstage than if you have to use all the internal amps in your receiver. When all of the amps inside of a receiver are being used during loud parts, the audio itself tends to get a little compressed when there's a lot going on screen. So having the Basics A7 handle all of your bed layer speakers, and having the receiver just handle the high channels, for example, the more action-packed parts with dialogue and sound effects and music blaring all at once will actually sound nice and separated and detailed instead of all muddled together. And lastly, how much is this going to set you back? The Basics A2 stereo amplifier is $449. The A3 and the A4 are $499. The A5 is $599. And the A7 is $699, which is honestly going to be your best bet because it roughly translates to spending $100 per channel of amplification. I honestly have yet to own anything Emotiva, but I guess from afar, I'm such a huge fan. I want to own a lot of their components someday, and that is my goal. But this next generation affordable line of amplifiers just makes me even more of a fan. Honestly, with this new generation of amplifiers at such a bargain price, there really is no excuse not to give your speakers more power and to put less strain on your receiver.
So there you have it, folks.
So, which amp are you gonna get? A2, A3, A4, A5, A7. Are you going to use it for your hi-fi setup? Or are you going to use it for your home theater? Let me know in the comments below. Once again, be sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss another video like this one. And of course, always be listening.